Mr. Chairman, let me introduce some of my experimental results concerning change of silico-optical properties due to fast hydrogen ion bombardment. The result was obtained in Kharkov National University. Outline of my report is the following: introduction, experimental setup, results, and conclusions. Let's start from introduction. Silica glass is widely used material in modern devices and facilities, first of all as insulator, as optical elements for diagnostics and optical and radiation transmission. It's well known that radiation by particles may cause change of silica engineering elements properties up to a state of non-operability, for example, transmission of Windows materials and other parameters. And the main reason for this is the formation and dynamics of radiation effects, defects of various types. That is why monitoring of silica optical properties under radiation conditions is an important task. Some words about defects in silica. On this picture, you can see a regular structure of silica, but we know that intrinsic defects, such as, for example, oxygen deficiency center, a non-bridging oxygen hole center, define optical properties of silica in visible and near ultraviolet range. And it's very important that long-time irradiation leads to substantial changes of light generation and absorption in visible wavelength range. Our bioluminescence technique. What is bioluminescence? Bioluminescence method is a powerful tool for investigation of processes in solids exposed to charged particle irradiation. What does it mean? We have solid, we have fast ions, irradiation of the solid accompanied by light emission in visible and near ultraviolet wavelength range. The process is well known as ionophilinescence. The reason for light emission lies in electron transitions and recombination processes occurring in outer electron shells of the solid atoms. What about our bioluminescence technique? The main basis is obtaining of bioluminescence spectra and use information from this spectra, information about internal processes of solid sample. What does it mean? There is a strong correlation between bioluminescence spectra and absorption dose of silicon. That is why there is a possibility to monitor silica condition under irradiation. Earlier, we have proposed a novel technique for this kind of diagnostic. Concerning my presentation, the idea was to use 210 keV for atomic mass unit hydrogen ion plantation for modeling silica optical properties behavior under irradiation. What was the process? The purposes of the research. First of all, we want to obtain spectral characteristics of silica irradiated by fast atomic and molecular hydrogen ions. Then we want to find influence of absorption dose on shape of luminescence spectrum, and finally, identify the contributions from various type of defects to luminescence radiation. Some words about our experimental setup. Experiments were performed in one degree accelerator, ion beams, hydrogen ion beams, some atomic and molecular impinged silica target. Spectra, radiation spectra were measured by a means of grating micrometer in visible wavelength range. So the orange implantation dose was 5 multiplied by 10 to the 10th degree gray. And some experimental results, important experimental results. First of all, on this slide, one can see luminescence cell spectrum evolution, this absorption dose. Two round is corresponding to the spectra at the beginning of bioimplantation and two at the end of implantation. From this slide we see two band structure. First band corresponds so-called blue band correspond to oxygen deficiency centers, such kind of defects in silica, and the second band, so-called red band, is associated with non-region oxygen hole centers. The most interesting for us was the region of maximum changes of spectral shape from 250 up to 700 nanometers. On this slide you can see in a large scale this region. There are two sub-regions on this spectra. First of all, blue band prevalence region, and the second one is a sum of comparable intensities from both types of defects. I mean, oxygen deficiency centers and non-bridging oxygen hole centers. And what we we performed mathematical treatment of normalized spectra to determine the contribution from each type of defects to luminescent radiation in this wavelength range. We analyzed a large array of experimental spectra and found that experimental spectra at wavelength range 590 nanometers could be approximated with high accuracy by exponential function. We can prove too. And what it was wrong reasonably to assume that luminescent radiation due to oxygen deficiency centers was described by this exponential function not only on this region but up to 700 nanometers. That is why we have experimental spectra Q1, we have exponential function Q2, and we subtract our exponential function from experimental spectra and obtained Q3, which corresponds to the non-bridging oxygen hole centers. And then we obtain absorption dose dependencies separately for oxygen deficiency centers, this, and for non-bridging oxygen hole centers. And we see that long wavelength of blue band was significantly increased with enlargement of absorption dose, and the red band intensity was decreased at the same time. And the reason for this, I mean, influence of chemically active implanted hydrogen on non-bridging oxygen hole centers brought to passivation of these defects. But there is a critical dose when our spectra infusion does not change. The possible explanation for this result is three processes defined evolution of blue and red band sheets. First of all, oxygen deficiency and non-bridging oxygen center production, annealing of defects, and defect modification as a result of hydrogen chemical activity. What does it mean? At the beginning of implantation, non-bridging oxygen hole centers production was predominant. Then, starting from a sorting dose, passivation by hydrogen became considerable. Balance between non-bridging oxygen hole centers passivation and production shifted to the former one. And in the end, at absorption doses, more than critical one, the dynamic equilibrium between three mentioned above processes was set. And short conclusions. Growth of absorption dose influence silica optical properties, namely luminescent radiation spectrum. Implanted hydrogen accumulation in silica led to non-vision oxygen flow center association, and consequently red band intensity decreased. At the same time, blue band intensity oxygen deficiency centers, as mentioned above range, increased. Dynamic equilibrium between defect production, aniline, and conservation was set to absorption doses more than critical one. Consequently, further radiation did not change the luminescent radiation spectra of silica being studied. And in the end, that's our experimental group. Thank you for your attention.
Good morning. Right then, questions?
This ionic luminescence method seems very similar to another material analysis method, also using ion beams, namely reporting to use X-ray emission. Do you know the differences between these methods?
There are many differences. In each method have pluses and minuses, but
What do you do different there? I mean, you fire an ion on the target and you observe radiation due to electronic transitions.
Yes.
Results from this bombardment. So what do you do different than when I perform PIXA?
Differences. Very similar, but it's. I'm not ready to answer that right now. What is the difference? I think that this method may be cheaper.
Why?
Because first of all, we tried to improve our method on ion beams from one degree of accelerator and other type of accelerators, but in the future we want to in situ observe an ion luminescence spectra without any sources of additional sources of ions.
Thank you. Ralph, quick questions.
Is there a difference between hydrogen atoms and hydrogen molecules in the response observable?
Difference between atomic and molecular. In our studies, the results was quite similar, but there are some differences, so-called molecular effects. It's present in our spectra, but concerning this research, the results was quite similar.
Okay, thank
and
you.
We have. We used the same energy, I mean the energy per atomic mass unit.
Okay, thank you very much.